Alright. We're officially live. I got my notification on my phone. Sierra Vista is live. Gotten to where it's better to start a minute early and give people a chance to kind of kick on their alarms to go off, all that kind of stuff. And for the people in the choir, there's a choir Facebook page that I made to communicate with folks that way too. And so I'm testing this thing that says cross post. So it's supposed to be on the choir page too. So I guess we're going to find out what happens. I don't know. I've never done this. Oh, got a couple of folks here. Hi, Cheryl. Hi, Lynette. So we're just kind of hanging out. Hi, Deborah. Got my Tennessee cup here. We won Saturday night, so barely. More, I usually wait till about time 4:32, 4:33 or so to do the official start. Galen, hello. People out in the hall. Busy, busy. If you guys haven't had a chance to come up and see the offices, you should swing by sometime and take a look. They're really great. Really love, beautiful, and lots of room for everybody. And I think Anne printed up our door plates. Those are fun to read. She's got some little funny comment for everybody. So right across the hall from me is the youth director when we get one. So I know the SPRC is busily working away at that. So hopefully, who knows, maybe in the next few weeks we'll have a youth director. I don't know. I don't have to do that. Hi, Kathy. The machine is telling me stuff. Okay. There we go. We'll wait a couple more minutes here. It's not even 4:32 yet, which is our official time. 4:32. God is faithful. That's what we're praying as we go through all this craziness together, the pandemic and all the difficulties that's caused. And it's been quite a thing to live through, that's for sure. Hi, Lisa. Give it just another minute here. My clock says now 4:32, but I'll wait just another minute. Because some people have their alarm set, like Pastor Stan talks about on Sundays. And so their alarms are just now going off. Yeah, there we go. God is faithful, 432. Thank you, Lynette. Okay. Well, gonna go ahead and kind of get started on what I want to talk about today. So, today's devotion or music note or whatever you want to call it, is about a guy named Rich Mullins, and he was a Christian singer, writer, back in the 90s mostly is when he was really well known, and was very popular. I am of the age that I was a high schooler in the 90s, so that tells now you know how about how old I am if you didn't already know. And so I lived through the period where Christian music, contemporary Christian music, became really, really popular. And we had folks like Amy Grant and Michael W. Smith and Stephen Curtis Chapman, and there were others, there were quite a few others that were really, really popular when I was in school that we listened to. And one of them was Rich Mullins. And he had a group that he called the Ragamuffin Band. And he wrote a book called The Ragamuffin Gospel. And he was sort of a rebel, I guess, in a sense. He didn't take much of a salary from his earnings. You know, a lot of the folks who have done music, Christian music, have made quite a bit of money, yeah. And there's not, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with that, but he did something really different. He got a firm to handle his money for him, and he told them, "I don't want to know how much I make. I don't even want to know what's in there. I just need this little bit to live on, and then everything else I want you to give away to the people who need it." So that was his view of the gospel and how we should live and how we should approach life, and that's pretty different. You know, that's pretty radical. I don't, you know, it's hard to say. I kind of look in myself and go, gosh, if I was making hundreds of thousands of dollars or millions of dollars or whatever, you know, would I have the fortitude, I guess, I don't know, to say, you know, no, just give me this little bit and give the rest away. I don't know. I don't know the answer to that. I probably won't. I'm not trying to become a famous rich artist, so you know, I probably won't. So most of us, you know, we look at hypothetical questions like that. We go, you know, who knows what would happen? Because we're probably not going to do that. But I think it says something about the type of person that he was and his character. Now, if you know anything about Rich Mullins, and I see a couple of you have posted that you're familiar with his music. Then you probably already know that he passed away in 1997 in a car accident. So it was very sudden. It was unexpected. He was young when he passed. I think he was 41, if I remember right. So, you know, he was making music still. It was really kind of at the height of his career. And before his death, he had moved on to a Navajo reservation and was teaching music to children. And again, it was another thing that people looked at Rich and said, "What are you doing? What is this? You know, is this some sort of, are you trying to say something? Like, what's going on?" You know, he just didn't fit the mold. He just didn't want to fit the mold. He was constantly searching. And as part of that, he struggled with alcoholism. He struggled with depression. But he always came back to God. He always came back to Christ. And you hear that in his music. Now, the song that I'm going to sing here in just a second is one that I actually was not familiar with. And if you watched the services yesterday, or if you were in the services yesterday morning, you heard a piece of this in the call to prayer. And Art Mavrode actually brought this to me. He sang in the service yesterday. And when he came in to my office a couple of weeks ago and was showing me the song he was going to do, he said, "I want you to hear this song." And so he played through it for me. And this song is part of the last album that Rich Mullins put out, and he didn't know he was going to put the album out. What happened was, after his death, they found a tape with songs that had not been recorded of his that he had done. And it's pretty rough. The recording is pretty rough because basically he just went in to a, I found out listening earlier, a piano that's not completely in tune, that's not fully up to pitch. And he sat down at this piano and he took a cassette recorder and just set it on the piano. And him and the piano on the cassette, he recorded these songs. I'm sure with the intention of, at some point maybe doing something with them or whatever. So they discovered these after his death, and they made this album. So the first part of the album is Rich singing the songs just into his cassette tape. And then the second part is that they've produced them, more professionally with other instruments and singers and whatnot to make them a little more, I guess, slick or, professional. So this song that Art brought to me that he sang a piece of yesterday is just called Jesus. And it's sort of a heart cry of when we go through these difficult things, when we have these moments in life, we can remember, we can go back to Christ and remember that, everything, the scripture says that everything that is common to man, Jesus was tempted by. So in other words, I think sometimes we think, oh, well, it's like, we get this idea of Jesus as this, that he's so much higher than us and that he can't understand, and that's just not the case. That's part of the reason that he came, was to be part of humanity and to show us that you can live in perfect harmony with God and with other people. It may cost you your life, as it did him, but you can do it. And that's what he showed us. So, no matter what we're going through, no matter the situation in our life, Jesus gets it, and he understands, and he knows. And, we can even rope in the part, his God part, his Godness, or however you want to say it. When we say, because you say something like that, and then there's always somebody who says, "Well, they didn't have computers back then. What does he know about somebody who, spends too much time on video games or whatever?" Right? Yeah. Well, he was still God, so he knew those things were going to happen. And when you break that down, what's it really about? It's about how we're spending our time and how we're exhibiting love in our lives, right? So anyway, that was Rich Mullins. Let me give you a quote of his that I thought was really beautiful and convicting at the same time. He said, "I would like to encourage you to stop thinking of what you're doing as ministry. Start realizing that your ministry is how much of a tip you leave when you eat in a restaurant, when you leave a hotel room, whether you leave it all messed up or not, whether you flush your own toilet or not. Your ministry is the way that you love people. And you love people when you write something that is encouraging to them, something challenging. You love people when you call your wife and say, 'I'm going to be late for dinner,' instead of letting her burn the meal. You love people when maybe you cook a meal for your wife sometime because you know she's really tired. Loving people, being respectful toward them, is much more important than writing or doing music." That kind of gets me. I'm convicted by that. I feel the weight of that, if you will. So, let me share this song with you. I hope that it impacts you. It did me. It's just a beautiful song. And you can look it up online and see the version. You can find Rich Mullins' version, or you can find the more professional one or whatever. But I'm just gonna sing through it with you guys today, and hopefully that it means something to you. They say you walked upon the water once.
just waiting to be touched. Jesus, write me into your story. Whisper it to me and let me know. They say you spoke in a calm and angry way. That was tossed across a stormy sea. Teach me how to listen, how to obey. Write me into your story. Whisper it to me. Let me know I am yours. Jesus, they drove the cold nails through your tired hands. Rolled a stone to seal your grave. Feels like the devil's rolled a stone into my heart. Can you roll that stone away?
I really don't even know what else to say after that. It's just, I don't know, it touches me, it means something to me. It's a beautiful song. I just hope that wherever you are, whatever it is that you're going through, whatever space your life is in right now, because, you know, we go through ups and downs, that we can always remember that there is someone who loves us, and that he's been through the things that we've been through, and that he knows how to reach out his hand to us and to calm the storm and to write us into his story, as the words say. And that's very comforting to me, and I hope it's comforting to you too. So that wherever you are, whatever it is that you're going through, whether it's good or bad, because let's remember to thank him in the good times, you know. And remember that, as the scripture says, in him we live and move and have our being. So I hope this was an encouragement to you today. I appreciate you guys for watching. I'm always grateful to everybody who takes a few minutes out of their day to spend it with us live, and for the folks who pop on later and watch it after the fact. And appreciate you guys supporting the ministries here at the church and being a part of those. A lot of great things happening. Don't forget to tune in on Wednesday for one of the pastors. I think it's Stan this week that's going to be bringing. I think that's right. I could be wrong, but I think it's Stan this week. So lots of great things happening here. Don't forget, we've got a Harvest Festival on Saturday. So if you haven't ordered your briskets or your chickens, I think there's still some briskets left. So you want to order those and swing by and get some pumpkins out of the pumpkin patch, and just be part of what's happening around here. Lots of great things happening, and I'm excited to be here, be part of it all. So appreciate you guys, and let's have a prayer as we close this time together. Father, we thank you that you sent Christ into the world so that we could have someone who understood us on our level, someone who understood us as humans, and that could relate to the human failings and frailties that we have, someone who could reach out his hand to us in those difficult times and who supports us always through the good and the bad, and who offers us ways to peace and joy and shows us how to love. I just thank you that you've done that for us, and that you just give us air to breathe and a beautiful sky above our heads. And I just thank you for all that you do here with the ministries at this church and for all those who are involved. And just ask you to continue to bless and guide each of us in all that we do. We thank you for the beauty of your love, and we ask it all in Christ's name. Amen. Thanks, guys. Appreciate y'all. Y'all have a lovely day.